Good evening, dear people of God. I welcome you again to this evening of Saturday, the 13th day of June 2020, to Let Us Pray program on Lagoon Radio and Television on behalf of the Right Reverend Dr. Humphrey Bamisebi Olumakaye, the diocesan and missioner of the Diocese of Lagos, Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. I am the Reverend Canon Samson Udoka Ilodibe. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, the God of all flesh, we thank you because you are God. We thank you because in you we live and move and have our being. Thank you, O Lord, for being our helper since morning till this evening. Thank you for journey mercies and strength for all we accomplish today. As we pray this evening, may your ears be attentive to our prayers in Jesus' mighty name. Beloved people of God, before we go into prayers this evening, let us read some scriptures. We shall take our Bible reading from the book of Prophet Daniel, chapter 3. Verses 26 and 27. Daniel chapter 3, verses 26 to 27. Then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire, and the princes, governors, and captains, and the king's counselors, being gathered together, saw these men, upon whose bodies the fire had no power, nor was an hair of their head singed, neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Beloved, from our passage, we see that our God is a miracle-working God. We see his power to save. We see that there is nothing too difficult for him to do. We see his mighty deliverance from the hands of the wicked. King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon had commanded that the three Hebrew men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that they be thrown into the burning fiery furnace for refusing to bow and worship the golden image he had made. He expected the fire to roast these men like chicken. But alas, after some time, the king himself was astonished because though he had cast three men into the fire, tied them up with chains, he could see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. Not only that, the form of the fourth man in the fire is like the Son of God. What a wonder-working God. In the king's amazement, he drew near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace, and immediately he acknowledged these Hebrew men to be servants of God. Oh, I pray for you hearing me this evening that your enemy shall acknowledge that you are a child of God, that you are a servant of God, and that you serve a living God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the three Hebrew men came out of the fire, the Bible recorded these four things. I want you to note them. Number one, the fire had no power on their bodies. No hair of their head was singed or burnt. Number three, their coats were not affected by fire. And number four, there was no smell of fire on them. I pray that no power of darkness will have any effect on your body in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to assure you, beloved, that if you serve God wholeheartedly and you do not bow or succumb to any form of idolatry, be it in your village, be it in your offices, be it anywhere where you live, even if you are thrown into fires of affliction by the enemy, the God that delivered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, he will also deliver you. I say he will also deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, this is an assurance from Isaiah chapter 43 verse 2 for you. He said that if you pass through the waters, I will be with you. If you pass through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burnt, neither shall the flame kindle upon you. I pray that this promise of God shall take place in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, this is an assurance from God who has sent his son Jesus Christ, the fourth man in the fire. His name is Jesus Christ. If only you believe in him, he will surely deliver you and he will set you free from all forms of chains of affliction of the enemy tonight. Let us pray. Please, I want you to say after me, thank you, Heavenly Father, for sending your son Jesus Christ to deliver me from shackles of sin, sickness, and sorrow. I want you to pray that prayer. Father, thank you, O Lord, for your children. Lord, thank you for sending your son Jesus to deliver us, O God. You said that whosoever the Son of Man shall set free, he is free indeed. Father, anyone hearing my voice this evening, Father, set him free from all the chains and shackles of Satan, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Again, please pray after me. Oh God, my Father, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but you say you will deliver them from them all. Papa, please deliver me from all the afflictions of Satan over my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, I want you to pray that prayer. Pray for deliverance from every afflictions. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Deliver your people, oh God, from chains and fetters of iron. Lord, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Again, say after me, you satanic yoke. Please say it like you mean it. You satanic yoke over my life, over my family, over my children, over my church, over my business, and everything that belongs to me. I command you to be broken now in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you pray? Can you pray? The Bible says that the anointing shall break every yoke. Every yoke shall be broken tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Finally, I want you to pray. Finally, I want you to pray with me. Heavenly Father, tonight, protect me and my family from all perils and dangers and from any satanic arrow. Me and my family, none of us shall be hurt in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, thank you, O God, that no satanic arrow will hurt any member, O God, of our household, O God. Anyone listening to me, Father, all the parishes in this diocese, O Lord, thank you, dear Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, O Lord, for this evening segment of Let Us Pray program, Grand Sound Sleep, and Good Night Rest to every member of all the parishes in the Diocese of Lagos, and any other person that have joined us in this prayer this evening. May we all be alive to see the next day, to continue to worship and to serve you all the days of our lives. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Beloved, again, thank you for joining us at this evening segment of the program, Let Us Pray. Please stay tuned to Lagoon Radio and Lagoon Television as you enjoy various rich spiritual programs. Please download the app Lagoon Radio for iOS and Android devices on Apple Store and Google Play Store. Join us also on our handle at Lagoon Radio Nigeria, one word. Also on Instagram and Twitter at Lagoon Radio NG. You can also join us for regular live video broadcast on www.youtube.com/LagoonTV. Once again, on behalf of the Diocesan and Missioner, the Right Reverend Dr. Humphrey Bamisebi Olumakaye, I am the Reverend Canon Samson Udoka Ilodibe, the Vicar of the New Covenant Anglican Church, Okeira, Ajah, Lagos. Good night, and remain blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.